Good to go?
Yep.
Swamp?
Alright.
Oh, my courier.
Alright.
Swing one.
Sure thing.
A year ago?
I'll draw. I'll play an island and a Bowmat carrier.
Oh, shit.
And I'll swing one.
All set?
Yep.
You're done.
I'll draw a card. Alright. Forgot to untap these. I'll play Darksteel Citadel. And. Oh, wait, I don't have. Yeah, I think I'll do this. I'll make this into a 5/5.
Oh shit, okay.
And I'll attack with it for 5 damage.
Okay. You got it.
Exile another card. And I will pass.
Draw. Aether hook? Swing 5. 5?
Yeah. Oh, right, I see. So I'll take down to 13. Right.
You go.
Draw my card.
You get an energy from the attack.
Oh, I do. Thank you, Matt.
Play another island, and I'll tap an island to play Blackstaff Waterdeep.
Man.
Oh yeah, go ahead.
And we choose another one too. Okay.
Should I attack?
Yeah. Okay.
I think I'll pass on attacking this time.
Okay.
Yes.
Beginning of upkeep, I'll spend 2 energy and a life to draw a card.
Okay.
Discard a creature, I get a zombie. That's wasted.
Draw another card. Dragon Skull Summit.
Thought seize. discard the land, I get two golden mana.
I'll pay energy for your red.
Okay.
Play Dreadhorde Butcher.
Okay.
Go ahead,
everyone.
Oh, yes, yeah, so let's see. I'm not super familiar with a lot of cards, so.
Fatal Push.
Oh, I see. So when it does damage.
That's right.
Okay.
Pay life. Keep it red. Another Dreadhorde Butcher.
Okay.
And then I'll swing. Okay.
I'll block one of the butchers.
Okay. So you would take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Okay.
And then he dies. And I'll deal 1 damage just to you directly. Wait.
Their powers are boosted from Judith, right?
Oh, so he would take 2?
Yeah, equal to its power. So it's a 2-1 right now, right?
So
yep.
Take 6. Yeah, I go down to 6 then.
And I will say pass.
Okay.
Hold on.
Oh, and then you take 1 from Judith too because a non-token creature I control dies.
So let's see. So the Glint Sleeve is a 3-1.
Yes.
And the other butcher's a 2-1.
Yes.
So that's 5 from combat damage, right?
Yeah, yeah.
And then 2 from the butcher dying.
So I go to 5?
And then 1 from Judith's trigger, right?
Yeah.
So it should be a total of 8 damage?
And you were at 13.
Yep.
So
okay.
That's correct.
All right. I guess at your end of turn, I'll activate the ability of this and turn the Darksteel Citadel into a 4-4.
Okay.
And then I'll untap. And then I'll draw a card.
I don't know if I'm allowed to, but I missed the Dreadhorde trigger because he hit opponent directly.
Yes, so there should be a counter on that. I knew we were missing something there. And then,
okay.
Is the Butcher... Never mind, it's not the same card I'm thinking.
So is that still a land? Can you still tap that?
Yeah,
oh,
it's a
okay.
Land. It's an artifact creature also.
Jeremy, can you bring the dice towards me a little bit? Yeah, perfect.
All right. I'll play another Darksteel Citadel.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll use Ensoul Artifact on that. So it can't attack this turn since it's just got played this turn. But... Oh. Maybe I think I'll just try to survive this next turn, and I'll just pass.
Man, this deck has way too many triggers for me. Just
yeah,
playing.
You also missed an energy.
Yeah, I did. Draw. So you have a total of 3 creatures on the board right now.
Yep.
Is this a 6-6 or a 5-5?
It's just a 5-5.
Okay.
Okay.
It's a 4-4. We land.
That's a good idea.
Yeah, I was like, I didn't see anything. I was like, oh, it should be fast enough. And then, like, I was going to take a couple of feet out.
PNLR.
That's cool, though. That card grows, especially since I'm like,
Opter.
Yeah, people just keep their hand out.
Yeah. Like,
okay.
I was looking forward to the corner. So,
the engine of the deck is pretty smart. You gotta live long enough to get this down and then start making a discard to get all this value.
Game one always gave for under and we'll
that. Oh, that's protection?
Yeah, it's a sick card.
Yeah. Instant, too.
Yeah. It's like the counter spell is out.
Combat. All right.
Yeah.
That one just came out, right?
Yep. So I'm gonna pay one mana, sacrifice it, and make it so.
Okay. So.
Your Darksteel can't block.
All right. My 4/4 can't block?
Yes.
Yep. All right, so.
Just back to my normal
I guess I'll block Judith and join forward. And I'll have the Darksteel Brock, the Butcher, and Bomat block Judith.
Okay. So
and then I'll take three. Oh, but then you could just shoot me with that, huh?
And then there's two from Bomet as well.
True.
Those blocks leave five.
Actually, I'll instead of blocking the Butcher, I'll block the Courier. So I'll block Judith and the Courier.
Okay.
But I probably still take enough damage to die.
Yeah, that's still six coming through here.
Okay. Well, that's game.
Them artifacts are no joke. When did those come out? Was that before?
Soul?
Yeah.
It was a thing very briefly. It's kind of like putting all your eggs in one basket.
Okay. Does it become indestructible?
Well, the Darksteel Citadel is.
Okay. But the
otherwise, the Bomat Courier is not indestructible.
Okay.
You actually didn't have to do anything there but attack, because the Glint Sleeve would have Menace, so it would get through, the other three would get blocked, and then when they died, two things in.
Okay. I see that. I just wanted to make sure that I could...
Plus the Butcher, when it dies, would do three anyways on its own, so... So much easier to navigate the game from here.
I bet. I really bet. Man, if you get those on the board, I'm in trouble.
Yeah, I was hoping to get a mountain so I could use my red spells, but... Or at least, like, use the bow mass to, like,
use it. It's a red deck, too.
Huh?
Didn't see any red cards.
No,
yeah, I didn't get any mountains.
No, I did not see any red.
And get some of those dual lands.
Are you new to the game?
I've been playing for about a month, so.
Okay. So, yeah, you're, like, fairly new. Which one did you...
Oh, right. Good question. Probably that way. I'm not actually sure. Could have just done nothing. Turn this back to 20. Okay. I like this.
I do as well.
I'll play first.
Okay.
All right, then I'll play a mountain, and I'll play a mat.
Okay.
And I will attack for one.
Get this shindig started.
Oh, yeah.
Discard. Waste not as the key card to the deck.
Okay. Mono white aggro.
Oh,
all right. Draw a card.
Canyonics.
And soul on a bowman. That's stupid.
I like it.
Yeah.
I think I'll play Experimental Synthesizer, exile the top card of my library, and I can play it until the end of the turn. I'll play an island so I can actually put it on the field.
Okay.
And I will attack with my Bowmat.
Okay.
To exile the top card of my deck and do one damage. And this is tapped.
Draw.
Yep.
I think I saw this deck yesterday.
Swamp.
They play Pioneer every Thursday. So I play chess on Thursdays. And it's cool because they're playing Pioneer, so I'm in between like Thursday or something.
Yeah.
In between, I'm just like, watching them play Magic too.
You play chess at?
Yeah.
You
AFK.
AFK.
Cut that.
Yeah, they have a chess level.
Okay.
Cool.
That does 4 damage.
Mm-hmm.
Alright. Then I will die. And these cards are exiled, right?
Yeah.
Are they permanently face down?
They are permanently face down.
Okay.
Here we go.
Alright. Draw my card. I'll play a mountain.
Chess
with that 3D chess.
Oh, God. No.
Really
make
it
into
my
brain fall out.
Yeah.
I guess I'll play Ensoul Artifact, and I'm going to use it on my synthesizer.
Yeah.
And I'll have it attack for 5 damage.
13.
And I'll pass.
Did you feel like playing tonight, man?
Skull Summit.
Another Pioneer deck just
came out, so. Switch every week.
Yeah.
No, sadly, I really wanted 5 color games. I don't think it's that good.
Bonnet?
It has to be good.
Right.
It doesn't have to be good. It helps.
You win more games.
You win more games.
Targets?
When the end goal is a turn, you're like, oh, I should probably
neat.
Take it.
Here we go.
You're not going to attack with the haste?
Nope.
Okay. Before end of turn, I think I will use Voltage Surge on your 3-2.
I was going to say, it's missing a lot of the early slivers.
It is absolutely missing.
I mean, it's a muscle sliver.
Right. And untap.
It's like the OG.
Yeah.
Draw my card.
But it's got some good ones, but it doesn't have the powerhouse one that it needs. It's got
play
a lot
an
of
island.
Utility ones.
I'll play Reality Chip.
Whom he'll do.
It lets me take a peek at the top of my deck.
Okay.
Okay. That's that. And I'll spend the rest of my mana to ensoul my main snare.
You get those a lot?
Yeah. I'll attack for 10.
Okay. I'll get a 3. Untap?
Yep.
Smoldering Marsh. I will say pass.
All right. Draw my card. Take a peek at the top card. Alright. I'll play Eater of Virtue, and I'll pay 1 to attach it to the Reality Chip.
Well, gosh, what does it do? How?
It just adds plus two, zero.
Plus two, plus
zero. So this is a 2-4 now.
Okay.
And I'll attack with everything.
I would much rather
look.
You got it.
Excellent.
No, I heard. It's, I came down here.
Jeremy, tell me the truth. Is that your old standard deck?
It's not quite. Not quite.
You changed a couple things.
Yeah.
I knew you kept it.
Huh?
I knew you kept your old deck.
Oh, yeah. It is very close. Just a couple of ads.
I should look at my sideboard.
There was a, are people already done playing? Was there a buy?
There was a buy, yeah. But also they're done playing. Because John Mark only plays mono white aggro.
Oh, they both play the same?
No. It was just mono white doing its thing.
Oh, like old school, probably like the 2-1s and Gideon. School to you. You gonna play Post Malone for 100k?
No. That is funny though.
I would love to do that.
Play him for 100k?
Yeah. I mean, I'm sure he's gonna kick my ass, but.
Shoot, you don't know.
That would be fun.
I know he has like unlimited.
Unlimited resources.
Right. Yeah. I'll be able to play.
All right.
Beat him with a pile of commons.
Shoot. He probably give you a tip.
Who played Popper Commander?
Oh, I'm going to ship. Spend the energy. Go to combat. Right. Swing one. You're going.
Which brings us probably to
point. Yeah, probably.
Right. Actually, before the end of the turn, I think I'll shoot that for 2 damage.
Okay. I'll do 2 to you.
Yep, sure. I probably should have done that earlier, but that's okay. And my turn, untap, draw a card, play a mountain, tap both, play Patchwork Automaton. And I'll pass.
Definitely in trouble. Remember that for us?
I can remember when I played.
That's what I said. I don't think it's a pretty powerful 5 minute effectively.
That was something that I really quick playing in person as opposed to being like, there's games I'll play on the internet, but not in person.
Absolutely.
Because there's so many triggers or counters or something.
My go? Yep.
Yeah.
Okay.
I can't do that in person.
Right. Draw my card.
No, that's a big one.
Tap one, play Experimental Synthesizer, add one to the counter, exile top card of my deck. I didn't play a land yet, so I'll just play that. And I'm going to spend 2 mana for Stone Coil Serpent. That comes in with 2 counters, this goes up to 2.
Mm-hmm.
And I think I'll pass. Oh wait, that can't block. Okay, whatever, I already
You read it though before, right? I think
yeah,
you picked up the card.
It just has so many words on it.
Yeah.
Sometimes I'm just like, oh, it's just a 3/2.
Yeah. Ward 2 is like, I have to spend 2 extra mana to cast a spell against it. Okay.
Yep.
Well, it's a trigger, so if they fail to announce it, then you don't. But.
Huh. Wait, that works like that?
Yeah, so it's a trigger when he targets your creature with it, you would announce the Ward 2.
I see.
And then it's countered, unless they pay 2, but if you miss your trigger, then...
That's fair. There has been times where I was like, didn't that have ward? I was like, oh, I should have paid 2 for that a while ago.
Yeah.
I heard that.
since the jig is in. Swing three.
So that's just a 3-2?
Yes, sir.
I'll just... I'll block it with my Stone Serpent. Yeah, just block it. So then I'll just...
You're good.
Right. I'll spend 3 mana to sacrifice this.
Make a 2-2?
Yep, it makes a 2-2 samurai with vigilance. And that'll exile the top card of my deck.
Is that graveyard now?
This is graveyard, yes. And I'll play Darksteel Citadel and tap it so I can play this from exile. And this will go to 3. And... I'll attack with my 4/4. And I'll pass.
Well, I told it to be forever to learn how to play that fucking white grid deck I was doing, and now I'm trying this one white.
Eventually got you.
Yeah,
sleep.
Alright.
Cooldowns command.
Okay.
I will have you discard a card and I'll deal 2 damage here.
Alright.
And I will attack with nothing and say go.
Alright. Draw my card. I'll play an island. Tap the island to play Black Staff. This goes to 4. And yes, I'll just attack with a 5/5. Probably should have attacked with the samurai too, but I forgot he was there.
All set.
All right, go ahead.
Dreadhorde. Go to combat.
Alright.
Swing 2. With menace.
I'll block with my sand. Oh, right. It's menace. Never mind then. And I take 2?
Yep.
15. And then my turn?
Mm-hmm.
Alright. Untap these. Draw my card. Play another mountain. And I'll pay the cost of this to turn this into a 4/4.
How much does it cost?
It costs 1 blue and 1...
Damn, that card's crazy. Okay.
And... I'll attack with everything. Well, this is vigilance, so...
So that's 4 and 5. I will... block the 2/2 of this and kill it with the extra damage.
Okay.
And then take 9.
Sounds good.
So I go to 7.
Alright. And
two energy and draw an extra card. Pay your life. Sack it. Here we go.
Right.
Get an energy back.
Huh?
Get an energy.
Oh shit.
Draw my card. I'll pay this and put Ensoul on my patchwork. So now it's a 9/9. And I'll attack with 9/9 and the 4/4.
Yeah. Well, I will. Block with one of these.
Alright.
Take 4.
Take 4?
Yeah.
Alright. And at my second main, I'll pay 2 red, sacrifice my staff and do 5 damage to you. Jeez.
Yeah. Okay. Good game, man.
Good game.